Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And if you're using Paginated Reports in Power BI, you are gonna be so excited about this new announcement that happened recently, and it's changing everything about your design of Paginated Reports. So, you know how I like to do? Enough of all this talk, let's head over to my laptop. I'm gonna set the stage just a little bit. So think about if you're using Power BI Report Builder and you have these two data sources. So just bear with me, I'm taking you on a journey here. And you wanted to leverage columns from each of these data sources in a single table. How do you do that? So I built out this table and I have all the information from my product table. So product is coming from Snowflake and subcategories coming from SQL Server. And so I added my products columns. And so the table automatically is going to say, hey, you can only use stuff from the products table, but I need some of these columns from subcategory in this table. How would you do it? I just can't drag or drop that column or add that column to this table. What I have to do is I have to write an expression that does a lookup. So it's saying join on the keys in the two tables. So that's what these first two parameters are, the keys from each table. And then this is what we're going to output from this particular data set. So that's my data set that's coming from SQL Server. And so you'd have to write that over and over and over again for each one of the columns that you want to include from the new data sets. And you need to have the join keys in both of those data sets. A lot of work with this new announcement, this new capability. You don't have to do any of that. So I'm gonna head back over to Report Builder and I started designing this report. If you click on data, you're gonna see the Get Data preview. They've brought Power Query directly to Paginated Reports. So all the sources, anything you wanna connect to, anything that you wanna use in your Paginated Report, any data source, it's directly built in. If you just click Get Data and choose more, you'll see all the options. You can even connect to Microsoft Fabric, Power Platform, databases like Snowflake and SQL Server and Microsoft Access. You can connect to them all. In this case, I've connected and you'll see my Power Query data source. But in this case right here, if I just right click, because I've already connected and done a little mashup, I go here and give me some data and wait, let me get my connection back configured up. Yeah, there we go. And so you can see all my data. If we go through the source, you can see my source is a lake house from Fabric. I also have a product table here that I brought in and then I merged those up. Okay, and it's outputting exactly what I want. But now, in my other example, remember I had that subcategory table in SQL Server. How would you do that? Would you use that lookup? No, look at this. In the Get Data experience, not only do I have access to all the sources, I can quickly combine to other sources. So if I just do this, load up my connections, I'm gonna click next. Then I'm gonna find my DIM product subcategory. I'm so excited. So I'm gonna choose my subcategory. I'm gonna click create here. Here we go. There's my subcategory. And then what I'm gonna do is go back out to my sales table. Now watch this, I'm doing this on purpose because I wanna show you something. And I'm gonna just say merge queries. And I'm gonna merge on my product subcategory key. And then I'm gonna go to that DIM subproduct category, merge on there. Ah, here we go, this is what I wanted to show you. It's saying, hey, you gotta do something. So if you wanna combine data sets, you need to set a property. So I'm gonna go back out and go to options and then go to privacy and say, allow combining of multiple data sources. There we go, click that. And then I can do my merge. And I don't need to use that lookup expression to join my data sets and pull columns. And I would have to write that lookup expression for every single column I want. Instead, I could do it right in Power Query. I said it before, I'm gonna say it again. It is available in Paginated Reports and Power BI Report Builder. And so now with one click expand, I can say I want all of the English, Spanish, French, and I don't have to write that expression over and over. And now you can see right here, I have all three of the columns. Now when I click create, I can just use this to build my Paginated Reports. What? It's exciting. What do you think? Have you played with this? Do you have other ideas or challenges that you face? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Power BI, Fabric, Paginated Reports, there's probably a video flying above my head. Check out that video. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Whoa.